मॉर्निंग चिल्ड्रन, इन द प्रीवियस लेक्चर ऑफ क्लास 9 केमिस्ट्री द चैप्टर वॉज लैंग्वेज ऑफ केमिस्ट्री. सो वी हैव ऑलरेडी डन द इंट्रोडक्शन पार्ट. इन द इंट्रोडक्शन पार्ट आई हैव एक्सप्लेन्ड यू अबाउट वॉट इज लैंग्वेज ऑफ केमिस्ट्री, अर्लियर अटेम्प्ट्स मेड बाय द साइंटिस्ट एंड केमिस्ट. नाउ टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू कंटिन्यू विद द फर्दर पार्ट ऑफ द लैंग्वेज ऑफ केमिस्ट्री चैप्टर, विच इज इन द लास्ट टॉपिक आई हैव टोल्ड यू दैट देर वर मेनी अटेम्प्ट्स मेड टू depict the symbol, or you can say representation of a symbol were being done by scientists and chemists. So the final attempt was made by IUPAC, that is International Union of Pure and Applied Chemistry. Okay, so they have given the standard units of symbol. Okay, now here you can see, as I am going to start with the further topic, which is your, that is symbol. Now what is a symbol? Okay, so let us start. See, as you can see, I have mentioned that some symbol is a short representation of an element. So it is a very short representation of an element. Each element is denoted by a symbol, which is usually the first letter of its name in English or Latin. So, which should be written in the capital. For example, I have mentioned here, carbon. Okay, it is very commonly, we all know that the common common representation of the carbon is your capital C, which is taken from its English word, that is carbon itself. Then you can see hydrogen. Hydrogen also, it has the symbol capital H, which is also again taken from its English word, that is hydrogen. Now when you see copper, okay, in copper the symbol is Cu. Now this symbol has been taken from the Latin word, that is cuprum. You can see here, if in cuprum, Cu is the first two letters. Okay, so this symbol of copper, Cu, is taken from the Latin word. Okay, now I am going to show you some more examples, because there are many elements which start with the same letter. Now, as we have already done, I am taking some examples, that is carbon. I am having calcium. Okay, then we have copper, then we have cobalt, then we have chlorine. Now see, here I have taken five examples. All of them are starting with the first letter C. Now see, when according to the definition, if you see, it is a short representation of element and it should be denoted by the first letter of its English or the Latin word. Now when you see here, all these English word consist of say common letter, that is C. So how you cannot represent all the elements with C? Now it will be very confusing. That carbon is also represented with C, calcium also C, copper also C. So this is not the perfect type of the representation of the symbol. So how to remove this confusion, okay, how we are going to represent? See, the first element, carbon, is represented with capital letter C from its English word. Then calcium. Calcium also has now C first capital letter. Now only one letter C cannot be represented for both the elements. Now what can we do further? So the rule says that we will also consider its next letter. So how I will write the symbol of calcium, that is capital C along with small letter A. So calcium ka jo symbol hai, that is your Ca. Now when you see copper and you see cobalt, hai na? So see, in this, copper and cobalt, both of them have first letter C. Second following letter is O. Now I cannot mention CO for both of them. This will be wrong. because symbol should be different for all the elements. So how we will represent for copper and cobalt? Okay, now let us see copper and cobalt. Okay, now cobalt K is represented by capital letter C with the following small letter O. So the first two letters is considered as a symbol for cobalt. Now about copper. Copper we usually represented with capital letter C and a small letter U. Now you will say that means there is no U in this word of copper. Hai na? So from where does this symbol has arised? So here this symbol is taken from its Latin name, that is cuprum. Now copper ka jo Latin name hai, its Latin name is cuprum. Okay, so this symbol Cu is taken from its Latin word. Are you getting? So according to the definition, symbol is a short representation of an element. It can be represented by the first letter of its name in English or in Latin. So you can see carbon ka capital C is taken from English letter. Then calcium Ca is taken from English letter. But for copper, Cu is taken from its Latin word, that is cuprum. Because copper and cobalt, both of them consist of same first and second letter. Hence, to remove this confusion, one symbol, that is cobalt ka Co, is taken from its English word. But for copper, the symbol is considered from its Latin name. Now, the last example you can see here, I have mentioned chlorine. Now, we know that chlorine we represent with capital letter C along with the small letter L. So, Cl is a representation of chlorine. Now, let us take some more examples of the same letter. Let us take another example. You have chromium. Now, see, chlorine and chromium, you can see both of them have CHCH. So again, we cannot represent it. Hence, for chlorine, we consider Cl and for chromium, we consider Cr. C along with this small letter R. And for chlorine, C along with the small letter L is the symbol of the element. Are you getting, children? So I will request you, whenever you have you get your textbooks, so kindly go through all the names and remember the symbols of the different elements. Now let us take some more example of some other element. Let us consider I am having sodium, I am having sulfur, and I am taking silicon. Okay, these three. Now see, all of them are starting with the first capital letter S. Now how do we represent the symbol? So for sulfur, I will represent with capital letter S. Okay, now for silicon, we represent capital letter S along with its small letter following small letter, that is I. So its symbol is Si. Now for sodium, children, sodium you cannot represent with S. Okay, and you don't represent with SO also. We represent sodium with Na. Now see, Na is not there in the English word of the sodium. So from where does this Na comes? Na comes from the Latin name, that is natrium. Sodium ka jo Latin name hai, sodium's Latin name is natrium. So from this natrium we get this symbol Na for sodium. Hence see here, again I am repeating, element can be represented by its first capital letter. The word either will be in English or from its Latin word. Okay, now see what is the further details of symbol. Significance of a symbol. Now what does symbol tells you? Symbol gives you information. First information is name of the element. Second is one atom of the element. The third important significance is quantity of the element equal in mass टू इट्स एटॉमिक मास और ग्राम एटॉमिक मास. नाउ यू कैन सी आई हैव मेंशनड हियर बिलो फॉर एग्जांपल सिंबल एन. नाउ व्हाट डज सिंबल एन रिप्रेजेंट्स हियर. सी हियर सिंबल एन व्हाट डज इट रिप्रेजेंट. इट गिव्स यू थ्री सिग्निफिकेंस. फर्स्ट इज नेम ऑफ द एलिमेंट. यू कैन आइडेंटिफाई फ्रॉम द सिंबल. If you will learn all the symbols, you will come to know the name of the element. So, what is the name of the element? The name of the element is nitrogen. Okay. Then, second significance is, it tells you that I have represent only one atom of the element. Single atom. Okay. So, it is one atom of nitrogen. It is what? One atom of nitrogen. Okay. Then, now quantity of the element equal in mass to its atomic mass or gram atomic mass. So I know that nitrogen's atomic mass is 14 gram. So these three information can be retrieved from the symbol. First is name of the element. Suppose symbol is your N, it represents its name, that is nitrogen. Second, it tells you the total number of atoms. So I have represented only one atom, so it is one atom of nitrogen.